Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today I'm going to talk about n queen problem. So you're given an n cross n board and there are n queens. You have to find any placement of these queens on the board so that they do not attack each other. For example, we have 4 cross 4 board and this is one of an arrangement such that these queens are not attacking each other. Here we're going to use backtracking to solve this problem and I'm going to discuss in a little bit how backtracking is going to work. So how does a queen attack? Queen attacks on the same rank, same file, and diagonally. So next, let's first talk about how do we find out if a square is under attack from a queen or not. Let's suppose the queen was placed at square 1, 2. So row 1, column 2. So all these squares will be under attack from this queen. Let's understand how. So all the squares which are on the same row will be under attack. All the squares which are on the same row will have the same row value as the queen's square row value. So 1, so 1, 0, 1, 1, and 1, 3. Similarly, all the squares which are on the same column will be under attack. So these are the 3 squares which are on the same column. And how we know that? Because the column value 2, 2, and 2 is same as the queen's square's column value. Finally, we have 2 kinds of diagonals. So one going from top left to bottom right and the other one going from bottom left to top right. For the ones going from top left to bottom right, these are the 2 diagonals 0, 1 and 2, 3. So to find out which are the squares, we use the formula row minus column. So if you look at this 1 minus, if you do row minus column here, this value will be 1 minus 2, which is minus 1. So any square whose row minus column value is minus 1 will be on the same diagonal as this queen, so they will also be under attack. So if you look at this square 0, 1, which is this value, 0 minus 1 is minus 1, and 2, 3, 2 minus 3 is also minus 1, which is this square. So both these squares are on the same diagonal of this queen, so they are under attack. For the other diagonal going from bottom left to top right, we use the formula row plus column. So this one is row minus column and this is row plus column. So if you look at this, 1 plus 2 is 3. So any square whose sum is 3 will be on the same diagonal as this queen. So 3 plus 0 is 3, which is this square. 2 plus 1 is 3, which is this square. And 0 plus 3 is 3, which is this square. And as you can see, they are on the same diagonal as queen, and so they are also under attack. So next, let's apply the simple formulas on a real example. As I said before, we are going to use backtracking to solve this problem. Since our board is 4 cross 4, our recursion will be 4 level deep. At the 0th level of recursion, we are going to place the 0th queen on the 0th row. At the first level of the recursion, we're going to place the first queen on the first row such that she does not attack the 0th queen. At the second level of recursion, we're going to place second queen on the second row such that she does not attack the 1st and the 0th queen, and so on. At any point of time, if we cannot find a square for a queen on that row, we're going to return a false to the calling function, and that level of recursion will then try to place the queen on the next available square of that row, and if that doesn't work out, then that function itself is going to return false to the calling function above it, and so on. Also, I've seen that a lot of people struggle with recursion. It really helps if you think of recursion as a tree, because then you can visualize how the recursive calls are going back and forth, and that is what we are going to do next. Also, to save on time, I have drawn some squares beforehand, but assume that when the recursion starts for the first time, only this 0th level exists. So next, let's do this example. Here we are going to place the 0th queen on the 0th column of the 0th row. So queen goes here, she goes here, and we are going to note the position 0, 0. Then we are going to go into the recursion and try to place the first queen on the first row such that she does not attack the 0th queen. So from here, we go into the recursion. So we cannot place the first queen on this square. We cannot place it on this square. This is the first available square, which is not under attack. So we're going to place the queen here. And in this recursion tree, I'm going to place the queen here. And then I'm also going to note this position 1, 2. And then again we're going to go into the recursion. So now we're going to look for the first available position for the queen 2. So this square is under attack. Why? Because it has the same column as this queen. This square is under attack. Why? Because the difference of the sum of row plus column for this particular position is 2 plus 1, 3, which is same as 1 plus 2, 3. So it must be diagonally with this queen, which is why it is under attack. Similarly, this this square is under attack from this queen, and this square is also under attack from this queen. So this position is 2, 3, so 2 minus 3 is minus 1, and 1 minus 2 is also minus 1, which is why it's under diagonal attack. So we figured out that we cannot place queen 2 on any of the square of row 2. So this function here is going to return false to the previous function, saying that I cannot find a place for the queen. So what this guy is going to do, or the first level of regression is going to do, is try to find the next available place for this queen. So it's going to place the queen here, or I'm going to say that I'm going to place the queen here. And in the positions, now we're going to say that the queen, the first queen, is placed in 1, 3. Then we're going to again look for, we're again going to go into the recursion and look for a position for queen 2, a square for queen 2. So this square is under attack from this queen. This square is available. So we're going to place the queen here. And in this recursion tree, we're going to place the queen here. And I'm going to note that I'm placing the queen on 2, 1. And then we're going to go again into the recursion, looking for a square for queen 3 on the third row. So this square is under attack, this square is under attack, this square is under attack, and this square is also under attack. So we cannot find a position for queen 3. So this function is going to return false, saying that I could not find a position for queen 3 on the third row. So then, the queen at the second row is trying to look for next available square. So this square is an attack from both the queens, and this square is also an attack from both the queens, which means that queen 2 cannot be placed on any further other squares. So this is going to return false to its calling function, indicating that I cannot find any other square for this queen. And we're going to remove this 2, 1 from my positions list. Position is going to store our final result. And this is going to return false to this queen. The row 1 queen is already, has already reached its end. So it will return false to the 0th level queen. So what we're going to do is we're going to remove this queen from here. And we're going to remove it from the positions. So then, this queen is going to place itself on the next available square. So the next available square is this, 0, 1. And then it's going to again go into the recursion. So then we are going to again look for a square for queen 1. So this square is under attack because 0 plus 1 is 1 and 1 plus 0 is 0, so it's on the diagonal. This square is under attack. This square is also under attack. This is the first available square. So queen will go into the recursion from this particular position. So we go into the second level of recursion, looking for a position for second queen. So this square is not under attack. Also, we're going to note its position, 1, 3. So this square is not under attack, so we can place the second queen here. Its position is 2, 0. And here, we're going to place this queen here. And then we go again into the recursion, looking for a square for queen 3. So queen 3 cannot be placed on this square. It cannot be placed on this square. It can be placed on this square here. So this time, this position is 3, 2. And this position is 3, 2. And now we have reached the we have done three levels of recursion. It means that we were able to place all the queens. So this is going to return true, this is going to return true, and this is going to return true, which tells this guy that all the queens were able to place themselves such that they are not attacking each other. And this here will be our final result. 0-1 this queen, 1-3 this queen, 2-0 is this queen, and 3-2 is this queen. So the time complexity for this algorithm is exponential because of this backtracking and going back and forth. In the worst case, it can go exponential. And the space complexity is O of n because our recursion in the worst case will be n level deep for an n cross n board. So next, let's look at the code for this algorithm.
The main function here is solve n queen one solution. So we are looking for one placement of n queens on n cross n board so that they do not attack each other. So, and the return type is an array of position which tells us the positions of all this n queens. First, we initialize this array for storing our intermediate and final result. Then we call this function solve n queen one solution util. To it we pass n positions and then 0. 0 is the 0th row from which we are going to start our recursion. So looking in this function, first thing we do is we check if n is equal to row. So row is 0, n is 4, so it's not true. So then we iterate through every column. So column goes from 0 till n and see which column on this row is safe. To do that, we check all the previous queens and see if the square is safe from the previous queens or not. So initially there are no queens, so we can place our first queen or our 0th queen on the 0th row and 0th column. So position is 0, 0. And then we put this into position array, so 0, 0, and go into the recursion. So this time we're going to pass row plus 1. So our new row value will be 1. And now again 1 is not same as n. So we again for loop for our column from 0 till n looking for a safe square for the first queen on the first row. So to do that we start, we look at all the previous queens. So we for loop through all the previous queens and see that they do not attack the square. So the square 1-0 will be attacked from the 0th queen. Square 1-1 will also be under attack from 0th queen. Square 1-2 is the first safe square. So we find the safe square, we put it into our positions array. And then we again go into the recursion with value row plus 1. So now row is 2. Again, row is not same as n. So again, we look for a first safe square for queen 2 on row 2 by checking with all previous queens. So initially column is 0, so we cannot place queen on this 2, 0. Next column is 1, we cannot place a queen at this square either because it's under attack from the first queen. We cannot place at 2, 2, and we cannot place at 2, 3. So we have to, we did not find a safe place. So our for loop went from 0 till n and we did not find a safe square for the second queen on the second row. So we break out of this for loop and return false. So when we return false, we tell the queen before this or the queen 1 that you got to find another safe place. So we come back from the recursion in the first queen, and since this if condition is not true, so we again go back and increment our column value and look for the next available safe position. So we are going to move our queen 1 to the next safe position, which is square 1, 3 again, and we're going to add that, we're going to update that in the position, and then we're going to again call recursion. So this time again the value of row will be 2. Again row is not same as n. Again we're going to look for a safe square for the queen 2. So 2-0 is not safe, 2-1 is a safe square. So we found a safe square for queen 2. So again, we are going to put that into position array, so 2, 1, and we are going to go into the recursion with row plus 1 value. So our row value will now be 3. 3 is also not same as n. So again, we're going to for loop from 0 till n looking for a safe square on the row 3. So 3, 0 is not safe. 3, 1 is not safe. 3, 2 is not safe. And 3, 3 is also not safe. So none of the squares on the third row is safe. So we are going to return false from this level of recursion to the calling function. So at the row 2, this is going to get a false, so it will not go into this if condition, and we are going to look for a next available column for the queen 2, and there is no safe column for queen 2. So we're going to backtrack a little bit more, and now we're going to look for next available safe column for queen 1, and queen 1 has already reached the end, so it's going to return false itself. So then we're going to reach row 0 and try to find another safe column for queen 0. So the next available column is this 0, 1. And that's where we're going to place the queen 0. And then we're going to again go into the recursion. So value will be row plus 1. So this this square is not safe. This square is not safe. This square is not safe. But this square is safe. So we found a safe square. We're going to place our queen 1 at 1, 3. And again go into the recursion with row plus 1 value, so row is 2. This square is safe, so we're going to place our queen 2 at position 2 comma 0 and add that into this array, and then we're going to go into the recursion with row value 3. So 3 comma 0 is not safe, 3 1 is not safe, 3 2 is safe. So then, since we found a safe square, what we're going to do is we're going to again go into the recursion with value row plus 1. So ultimately, we're going to reach this point where n, which is 4, is going to become equal to rho, which is also 4. So we're going to return true. So what this means is it returns true here at the third level, at the row 3 level recursion. So that guy will return true to row 2, and row 2 will return true to row 1, and row 1 will return true to row 0, and row 0 will return true ultimately to this function. Solve n queen 1 solution function. And then, since this solution exists, then we are going to just return the contents of the array, which is positions. So 0, 1, 1, 3, 2, 0, and 3, 2. So this is the entire recursive algorithm for n queen solution. If you want to see all possible solutions, not just one solution, I also have this code here, solve n queens. And if you're interested, you can look at this code as well, and this code is not very different from the previous code. So this is all I have to talk about n queen problem. Please like this video, share this video, comment on this video, check out my Facebook page, and check out my GitHub link. The link to this code is in the description section of the video. Thanks again for watching this video.